G'day YouTube, blonde ale today. I'm going to pour it out right after the brew day, which is now.
Okay, yeah, we've got the crush there. 6.5 kilos, trying to aim for a bit higher alcohol on this one. I used 50 grams of Hallertau metal through all up. Here's my strike water. And here's what it looks like when I've dough'd in. Dough'd in at 68. No, it was about 73 actually I dough'd in at, 90 minute mash. And it finished up at, it was 66 for the 90 minutes. Yeah, look, it looks very porridgey. First runnings, just ran off. Ran and ran and ran until it was as clear as I could get it. Took a long time to get clear, this beer. I'm not really sure why, just kept running it through and recirculating, and you can see the end product there. It's pretty clear, a lot clearer than what I've had in the past, and that's my final runnage. I did another sparge in between there, and yep, boil up 30 grams of Hallertau at 60 minutes and 20 grams at flame out, and there's my Irish Moss at 15. Okay, and there's the ferment, just bubbling away nice and quietly. Temperature probe, keeping nice temperature, continually fermenting. Try to show you the temperature here, but that didn't work out so good, so you can't really see it. There we go.
Okay, Brewed was pretty good, pretty easy, not a big issue. Alright, let's taste the beer. Nice clean glass. Straight up, I don't know if you can see that, pretty good carbonation, very well carbonated. It's about a week, well, probably 2 weeks old, and it seems to be going okay with carbonation. It might be the glass that I've got, the head sort of has died. I have had others. I have had a couple of these, so yeah. Since they were fully carbonated, and yeah, the head was a lot better on those. Straight up front, you've got a little bit of malt aroma. Tiny little bit of Hallertau behind it, but not a lot. Clarity's not very clear, a little bit of chill haze there, but clear enough. Yeah. I like that little bit of Hallertau. I dry hopped it with about 10 grams of Hallertau, about a quarter of an ounce, I suppose. Just over a quarter of an ounce. But you can just pick that up, just barely. And in this style, you probably don't want want too much hop aroma and hop flavour anyway, but the malt comes out pretty well. All right, for a taste. Yeah, straight up front you get that malt, a little bit of bitterness in the background, not a lot. I didn't add a lot in the way of bittering hop addition. I use Hallertau as the single hop for this. Comes in at about 6% ABV. I know that's a little high for a blonde ale, but I wanted something that was unoffensive, something that had reasonably high alcohol so I could serve it to guests, and something that mimicked Australian beers. And pretty much this, if you have a look at that, any Australian that's ever drank a beer in Australia knows that that's exactly what an Australian beer looks like. And I wanted something that would introduce people to some of my friends to not craft beer, but to homebrew without hitting them with something like an Imperial Stout or something that was way out there and they couldn't understand the flavours and it's really hard to explain. Malt bill on this, I think I looked at about 6 kilos of two-row pale, about 500 grams of carapils, which is 10 lover bond or something like that. And that sort of filled the malt bill. I think it was 30 grams of Halotau at 60 minutes, might even be a little bit less. 20 grams of Halotau at 15 and 10 grams after 7 days in the primary. It wasn't in the primary for long. I bottled it up straight out, just a primary fermentation. Left it two weeks, I think. And then I bottled it straight up once it was complete. But it looks okay. A little bit of chill haze. I'm having a little bit of trouble with chill haze, and I think that's got to do a lot with the way that I chill. When I pull my wort out of my boar kettle. But I'll work that out. It's going to be nice and refreshing for summertime. Thanks very much, YouTube. Thanks for watching. See you later.